Hi friends, now we are going to see the problems based on ratio and proportion. Ratio and proportion. Now here we are going to discuss about the proportion. Proportion gurinchi manam discuss chesam. Okay, ippudu A ratio B is equal to A ratio B and C ratio D. A ratio B and C ratio D. See here, it implies A ratio B is equal to C ratio D. Then we can write it here as A column B is equal to C column D. Then here A column B is equal to C column D. Again we can write it here as A by B is equivalent to C by D. Then A by B is equal to C by D. The four are in proportion, right? This four are in proportion means we can write it here as A, B, C, D are in proportion. A, B, C, D are in proportion. Then we can write it as how we will write the proportion here. See, A column B, C column D. Here proportion, it implies it is, if there are two ratio symbols, then it is called as proportion. Okay, two ratio symbols, it is called as proportion. Now here A and D are called as exchange terms. A and D are called as exchange terms. And here see, here A and B are called as exchange terms. And what B and C are called? B and C are called as means. B and C are called as means. Now see here proportion terms. A ratio B proportion, C ratio D. Now we can write it as A ratio B proportion, C ratio D. Here we can write it as multiple of exchange is equal to multiple of means. We can write it as multiple of exchange means A into B. Multiple of exchange is A into D is equal to multiple of means. Multiple of means means B into C. Now this is called as multiple of exchange is equal to multiple of means. Okay, in this way we can find the proportion. Okay guys, thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe.